Welcome to Business World. I'm your host Siddharth, and today I'm with Mr. Sharad Agarwal, the Lamborghini head for India, and Mr. Matteo or Tenzi,
right,
APAC head for Lamborghini. Today we'll be talking about various things related to Lamborghini. So this is a very informal chat, and let's start with the questions. So Lamborghini, as we all know, has a rich history of super sports cars, but no SUVs. So why did Lamborghini need an SUV in its product portfolio?
So Lamborghini is coming for a very good growth period, and we were deciding how to develop and how to grow again. So thinking about the third model, then we decided on the Urus for several reasons. First of all, it's not an SUV, so it's a super sport car with the shape of an SUV. So it was able to combine performance and emotion with a very good flexibility of the car. So with this, we were able also to go closer to the customer that were looking something more flexible, that they need more space, that they wanted to drive even more our cars. And that's why then at the end we had the decision of the Urus. And then we are a company, and the SUV segment is one of the most successful segment in this period in the world, in all the markets. So the segment is growing, and these were the drivers of our decision.
So since Lamborghini has never had experience in building SUVs, so what were the challenges faced by the company while building the Urus?
As you said, it was our first time. Okay, we had the LM002, but it was a different car, and we had a different company. The point is that the big challenge we had, it was to have a super sports car with a different shape. So we had not just to do the step to build an SUV, even if we never did. We had to do an SUV having the same feelings when you drive of a sports car. So it was a double challenge for us. But we were preparing the company properly. Think about that 2.5 years ago, the surface of our plant was 80,000 square meter. Actually, it's under 60,000 square meter. So we doubled our plant. We are 400 headcounts in the last 3.5 years, just to develop the SUV. We are preparing our dealer network. So it was a jump, but it was done with all the effort and with all the necessary preparation before. At the end, the result you see are now on the road, we were able to do it, even if for sure it was a big effort for us.
Okay, this question is for both of you. What makes a Lamborghini a Lamborghini?
I think it's not a car which you drive from point A to point B. It's all about the emotions, the experience, what you enjoy when you are driving a Lamborghini. And for me, it's our DNA, which is design, driving dynamics, and the emotions of the car, and how you give a customer those experiences in a very intuitive way, which he can carry and enjoy. It's a different thrill. To me, that's Lamborghini.
So I have a very simple index if we did our job or not. The first time that we are let drive a car to our customer or potential customer, if they go out of the car and they smile, then we did our job. So if we're able to provide emotions, then this is exactly what we have to do.
In a 14-year long career with Lamborghini, could you give us some memorable moments?
We can stay here some hours if you want, on the main important ones. So I remember the start of production of the Aventador was a very important moment for us. And also because I was involved since the beginning in the project team of the car. So for me, it was really the moment. And then the one I'm living in these days, because since 2015, I was the head of project management. So I was really close to the development of the Urus. And now I'm finally the one responsible in the Asia Pacific to bring the car to the markets. And this is something that is very good for me.
India is number 3 in the auto sales in globally, right? But Lamborghini, how does it make sense to be in India? The volumes are very low. India is catching up. It will be there eventually. But how does it make sense for Lamborghini to be in India?
So firstly, when we look at any market, we don't look at from a short-term perspective. You always look at a market from a long-term perspective. And what India has shown is that the market is growing. The customers has preferences towards these luxury and lifestyle, and you know, something as exclusive as Lamborghini, and that this made us, you know, to take the decision that yes, we should go to the country. And then the next step is that how you want to approach the market. So as Lamborghini, we took a very important decision in 2012 when we said that we will create a structure and team, and we look at a very long-term view. We will create facilities and we will give experiences to our customers in sales as well as in after sales, which are equivalent to international standards. And we have consistently grown. The market has rewarded us with the leadership position, and now we have Urus in India, which is going to take our business in India to a completely new dimension. So what we anticipate today now, that whatever work we did in the last 3-4 years in the market in terms of understanding, building a network, building the quality processes, experiences to our customers, when we have the right product like Urus for the Indian market, we are going to grow exponentially. So we anticipate that we should double our volume in next 2 years, which is going to be phenomenal, and we will be in a different dimension altogether.
Sharad is fully right. So we are not looking for short-term investments. India has a big potential, that's why we want to be here. And we, as you said, with the right structure, developing our dealer network. And also, it's true, now we have the right product because it's really fitting the Indian market, also for the infrastructure we have in India and the traffic condition. For sure, the Urus is easier to manage, comparing a real sports car like Huracan or Aventador. But we will never forget the attention that we have on these two products. So the sports cars are very, very important also for India.
Yeah.
And we had very good reaction when we were presenting here at the top of our range. So with the Performante and the Huracan, the SV that we had on the Aventador, the SVJ that has to come and will come also in India. So I think the potential is for sure for the new product, but we see that the culture of the luxury cars and sports cars is really growing in India. That's right. Why we want to be here.
Electric vehicles are the future. Everybody is talking about it. Now then we have super quick electric vehicles. Certain vehicles doing excellent speeds. So do we expect a very fast supercar in electric from Lamborghini?
You touch a very important point. You said super quick, but we have to define what does it mean super quick.
Yeah.
So if we have to build a car that is very, very fast in the 0-100, but then in driving dynamics is very poor, yes, maybe with the electric engine you can do it. What we are looking for in Lamborghini is the performance, is the durability of the performance, is the balance of the car. So we will never compromise about emotion and performance. The actual technology is not able to give these things to our customer using an electric engines. Even if there are some experiments at the moment of electric cars that are really fast, they are fast for a very short period.
Right.
Try to do one or two laps of Nürburgring with an electric car, and then you will discover why we are not stepping into now. So once the technology will be ready, and we will be able then to give to our customer the right level of performance, the right level of emotions, then we will be very happy to go forward in the electrification trend that is effect, so nobody is hiding. But we have to do it in the proper time and in the proper way.
What is your favorite Lamborghini?
In my opinion, it's the most beautiful car in the world. So, and that's clear to me. But as I was telling you before, so being in the product team of the Aventador, this was my first love working in Lamborghini, and this is a very important car to me.
Force induction and downsizing is the current trend because of emissions. So is Lamborghini going to give up the famed V12 and come down to turbocharged V8 and V10s?
Let's say it depends by the car. So today we are here to launch to the press the Urus. For the Urus was the right decision to have a turbo engine. For these big cars with a big mass, you need torque. You need torque in a very low rev, and this was the right decision. In the sports car, what we believe is that the natural aspirated engine is giving the right response to the throttle, the right emotions when you're driving, the right feeling. That's why we didn't compromise and we didn't do downsizing in Huracan and Aventador. And to be honest, I don't think that this will be the end of the V12 natural aspirated. Maybe we will combine them with an hybridization in future in one of the next models. But I think in the sports car, the natural aspirated engine is still the right decision.
Yeah, it is. Self-driving cars are the future. So how is Lamborghini preparing for that?
I think Lamborghini is more about driving emotions and experience in the car. to me, if I have to imagine a self-drive in a Lamborghini, I will say that the features which adds to the safety of the driver will be part of our cars. But then people come to Lamborghini to drive, to enjoy the thrill, to enjoy that experience, and we will never take that away from our cars, and they will always be part of our cars.
A self-driving Lamborghini will not be alive.
I think it doesn't look to me, you know, I can't even imagine a brand Lamborghini and a self-drive car.
Maybe in certain specific traffic condition or something like this, it could be developed in future, never say never. But the point, Sharad is right, so it's not a car that is bringing you from A to B. And for sure we can develop something that is enhancing the driving the driving capability,
yeah,
and the driving experience. This is something that for sure we will look carefully on. But just to move from A to B without touching the steering wheel, I think this will be hard for Lamborghini to do.
How many Auruses are you planning to sell in India, and what is the reaction that you've got from your current customers?
So the response has been very encouraging from the market for Urus. We are sold out for 2018 volumes, what we planned. And we are now anticipating that with the complete supply and availability of Urus, we should be able to double our volumes in India over the 2017 achievement. So this means a complete change in the dimension of business what we are doing. And from there onwards, we anticipate that we will continue to grow and build consistency in our volumes.
What are your current sales figures for the models that you are selling in India? And how does it compare with similar markets like Brazil and Mexico maybe?
So coming to the super sports car segment, because that's the segment which we are, you know, currently presenting, the size in India is approximately 70 cars, and we are the market leaders with approximately 40% of the share. Coming to Brazil, I think, Matteo, you can have better insights on that, how it is vis-a-vis India.
Yeah, we are bigger than the actual market in Brazil. That was also eaten by up and down, given by taxation changes, so it was not a constant market.
Yeah.
And the outlook is for sure to grow. Also, looking at the Asia Pacific markets, I think India will do step forwards also to overachieve other countries that at the moment are higher than India in terms of sales numbers.